At Listen Up, we care about what you think. Pop by our website and answer this week's question. What are you looking forward to in 2010? You'll find us at listenuptv.com. Welcome back. We're looking at some of the top stories of 2009. When polygamy hit the headlines in Canada this fall, Listen Up's host and executive producer, Lorna Duick, spoke to a woman who'd lived in a polygamous marriage for 28 years.
What would you say to our country as it starts a public discussion on polygamy?
Well, first, I would say I think that everybody has rights to their religious freedom, but I do not think that they have a right to hide the abuses, child abuse and women abuse under the guise of religion. And that is exactly what is happening. It's abuse when young girls are told who they have to marry and they marry men old enough to be their fathers or their grandfathers. And it's abuse when mother and daughters are married to the same man. And it's abuse when these children have no education. They run the boys out of town so the older men can marry the younger women. And it's abuse when you have no schooling, no job skills, and when you are forced into having a baby almost every year and have anywhere from 12 to 21 births. It is abuse. And I feel that for Canada to pass a law and let them go ahead and do it is nothing but shoving women underneath the rug. Women in these polygamous situations are never even allowed to vote. We can do nothing politically, and we have given up our identities. And I just don't think at all that it's a good idea.
A court challenge designed to legitimize prostitution brought us into contact with John. Once a man who paid prostitutes for sex, his life collapsed in rubble when his wife and his employer discovered the truth. But when John shared his story of recovery with us, it was not a sense of despair, but one of hope and redemption that surfaced.
I think God likes me a lot. I mean, I think God's relationship with me hasn't changed. Because God has always been with me, even when I was in those broken places, and whispering, saying, this is not for you. There is more for you than this. And it took God finally saying, I'm tired of you doing those things. And he grabbed hold of me, and he brought light into my life and brought gracious people around me. The things of my life, of my past, are so sad and broken that to now be able to say, God, I'm good. And God says, I know, I'm good. I'm good with you too. And so I am really thankful that that there is a God who does not give up.
If there was one thing that dominated the headlines throughout the year, it was the H1N1 outbreak. Listen Up brought you the story of Reverend Perry Chernesky, a church pastor and married father of two, who lost his life to the virus in the first wave of the pandemic.
He was the 32nd Canadian to die with H1N1 virus in his blood. Before he got sick, he was your average healthy middle-aged husband and father.
His first symptoms were a cough, the chills, a fever. He said he was tired, he would wake up exhausted in the morning. His cough got wetter and deeper, and at that point we were concerned that maybe he had pneumonia.
Perry Chernesky was only 42 when the H1N1 virus rampaged through his body. He loved his music, loved his wife and kids, and loved the Oakbank, Manitoba church he led as pastor. Just days after he was diagnosed with H1N1, he was gone.
Why are you so sure Perry is in heaven?
His amazing faith in the Lord. And the amazing promises in the Bible, because Jesus promised that those who believe in him will not perish but have an everlasting life. He said anybody who comes to him, he won't cast out. He promised that he died for our sin, that we don't have to be worried, that we don't have to be enemies of God. And that's how I know. You just come to him. You come where you're at. You come just who you are, where you're at. It doesn't matter what kind of weaknesses you have. It doesn't matter what kind of problems you have. Jesus will meet you there. Everybody can die. Everybody will die. It's just a matter of time. You need to be prepared. That's the sermon Perry preached too. Be prepared, you know, because you never know when it's going to happen.
What is your advice for us?
First of all, don't be paranoid. Perry was sick as early as Friday. We know that for sure. He performed a wedding on Saturday. He performed the church service on Sunday. So he exposed probably 300 some odd people to H1N1 and nobody got sick. He exposed his family. We didn't get sick. So, you know, don't be overly paranoid. Wash your hands, keep things clean, but don't be afraid to live. The other advice I would give people is, like I said, be prepared because this life is short, very short, and it can be over in an instant.
When we return, we'll close out the year with some final reflections in the wrap.